Hi, my name is Mary Gross. I'm a fitness instructor here at ProMedica Forever Fit. And today I'm going to teach you some Tai Chi warm-up exercises that focus on balance. This is just a few of the many Tai Chi exercises that we have for our Tai Chi for arthritis and fall prevention program here. So before we get started, just make sure your area is clear so you won't trip on anything if you have rugs or weights laying around on the floor. And you also might want a chair to assist you on the balance. We're gonna start with the wushu greeting. I'll teach you that too. So take one fist loosely, like you could be able to see through it. This represents strength. These four fingers together represent community. The thumb pointing in represents humility. And then this is our greeting out of respect for one another. All right. Okay, one of the basic principles to Tai Chi is slow and continuous motion. It's as if you're in a body of water and you have this gentle resistance in it. So you want to keep that in mind as we're exercising today. The Tai Chi stance is with our feet about shoulder width apart, and we also want to always keep our joints slightly bent in our legs and in our arms and throughout our body, because that helps the chi or the energy flow in our joints. Having said that, we'll practice our breathing because that's very important for balance as well. So go ahead and put one of your hands about two finger lengths underneath your navel, other hand on top. So we're gonna breathe through not only the lungs, but blow up the balloon in your lower abdomen and exhale and pull up that pelvic floor. Inhale. You get about 20% more lung capacity when you do that. Exhale, pull it up. So we want to use this Dantian breathing throughout our exercises today. All right, so think about that while we're doing our stretches. We're going to start out with the hip stretches. Remember that Tai Chi stance. Think about our tailbone pointing towards the floor and a string coming all the way up our spine through the crown of our head. All right, go ahead and extend and stretch the arms in front of you. We're gonna weight shift to one side and dig one heel into the floor, arms come back for counterbalancing. Bring it back, toe heel comes down, weight shift, and remember your Dantian breathing. And if you want, you can go ahead and hang on to the chair if you need that to assist you. Toe heel, weight shift. So the weight stays in the back. Stretching out your hips and digging that in. So you want to do these stretches at least three on each side. Another hip stretch, get back to that Tai Chi stance. Pretend there's a wall here and we're going to press against the wall and stretch that leg out. Toe heel, weight shift, stretch. Pressing against that wall. Remember to keep those legs bent and keep the breathing slow. Press against that wall and stretch. Toe, heel, weight shift. You never want to pick that other foot up until that stationary foot is all the way down. Let's try that one more time. You could even clean the rice bowl out and stretch. Make sure that foot's all the way down. And stretch. Very nice. All right, next we're going to do some knee stretches. You could go ahead and shake it out a little bit. For the knee stretches, we're going to have those loose fists. You should be able to see through them. Keep them by your hip. Now we're going to do more weight transfer between the feet and the legs. Weight shift. We're going to punch opposite of the toe that's dipping in the water. And toe heel down. Weight shift. Remember, you always have that chair there in case. Well, I had to use the same arm for that because I had the chair, but that's not a big deal. Tap that toe in the water and back. Weight shift. If you feel comfortable and confident with this, then you can lift it up a little and kick, stretching out that knee joint. Same thing other side, or you could just kick lower too. That will work. All right, the second knee stretch exercise, we're gonna use those fists again at our hips. We're gonna do the weight shift, heel toe, weight shift forward, punch. Bring it back to the hip, peel that foot off the floor, toe heel, weight shift, heel toe, forward punch. See how my body is still upright from the tailbone to the crown of my head. Let's try that one more time. Slow motion, just like in the movies. Peel that foot off, toe goes down, keeping the breathing slow, toe heel, weight shift back, peel that foot off. All right, those were the knee stretches. Now on to the ankle stretches. I like to put my hands underneath my belly button and practice the Dantian breathing when I do this. So go ahead and take a few breaths. And let's do the weight shift. We're gonna go heel, toe, heel, toe one more time, and then bring it back. Same thing other side. And if you want, at any time, use the chair to assist you. Heel, toe, heel, toe. One more time and bring it back. Great. Now let's try another ankle exercise. Outside of the foot, inside of the foot. Outside and again, use that chair whenever you need to. And inside. Foot comes back in. Weight shift, outside of the foot, inside of the foot. One more time. Great. And we'll finish with some healing breaths at the end. Go ahead and sink your knees down a little. Get that great Tai Chi stance that you've had already. Let's inhale and exhale. Inhale the positive, exhale the negative. Inhale healing and restoration. One more breath. Great. Well, thank you for exercising with me today and trying these stretches. As you can see, we focused a lot on weight transfer and slow, mindful stepping. Let's finish with our Wushu greeting.